Welcome to a new Ignition Gazebo tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to add sensors to our robot and to other models in our world. We will introduce three different sensors: an IMU sensor, contact sensor, and a LiDAR. But the process is very similar for most of the sensors. We will also learn how to launch multiple tasks with just one file using Ignition Launch. You can find the final world of this tutorial in the description below. The Inertial Measurement Unit, or IMU, outputs the orientation of our robot in quaternion, the angular velocity in the 3 axis, and the linear acceleration in the 3 axis. Let's use our moving car SDF world and modify it. Create a new file, sensortutorial.sdf, and add the code from movingcar.sdf to it. To define the IMU sensor, add this plugin under the world tag. This code defines the IMU sensor plugin to be used in our world. Now we can add the IMU sensor to our robot. The sensor is usually added to one of the links of our model. We will add it under the chassis link as follows. We define the name and the type of our sensor, which is IMU sensor. In the always on tag, if true, the sensor will always be updated according to the update rate. In the update rate, we specify frequency at which the sensor data is generated. In visualize, if true, the sensor is visualized in the GUI. The sensor is being visualized in the GUI depending on if the sensor supports visualization or not. In the topic, we add the name of the topic in which the sensor data will be published. Let's have a look at the IMU data. Launch the world in one terminal. Press the play button. In another terminal, listen to the data sent over the IMU topic using this command: IGN topic -e for echo, then -t for the topic. The IMU data are the orientation, angular velocity, and the linear acceleration. These values will change as our robot is moving. It depends on the direction and the speed of the robot. Next, we will add the contact sensor. You can guess from the name that this sensor gives indication when it touches something else. We will build an obstacle and add the contact sensor to it, and if the robot hits the obstacle, it will stop, preventing the robot from damaging itself. Add the obstacle to the SDF file as follows. It is just a simple model with one link of a boxy shape. Check the Build Your Own World tutorial to know how to build models in SDF. The link is in the description below. Now, if we run our world, we will find the world model like this. To add the contact sensor to the world, we should first define the contact sensor, as we did with the IMU sensor, using this code. We just added the contact sensor plugin to our world. Then we can add the contact sensor to the box link of the wall model. The definition of the sensor is straightforward. We just defined the name and the type of the sensor, and inside the collision, we defined the box link collision name, which is collision. We need also to add the touch plugin under the wall model. The touch plugin will publish a message when the wall has been touched. In the target, we define the target which will be in contact with our wall, which is the vehicle blue model. Then, the name is based of our topic. So, when our robot hits the wall, it will send a message to wall touched topic. Now, we can use the triggered publisher plugin to make our robot stops when it hits the wall. The triggered publisher plugin publish a user specified message on an output topic in response to an input message that matches user specified criteria. In our case, when we receive a message of data true on the topic wall touched, the triggered publisher will output a message on the topic CMD velocity type of twist with this value. 0 in the linear and 0 in the angular to make our robot stop. Let's see if this is working. Launch the world. Press the play button. Then we will move the robot forward using this command. The robot is moving forward. And when it will hit the wall, it will stop. We don't want our robot to touch the wall at all, because this may cause some damage. So, instead of the contact sensor, we can use the LiDAR. LiDAR is an acronym for light detection and ranging. This sensor can help us to detect obstacles around the robot. We will use it to measure the distance between our robot and the wall. First, we will create a frame to fix our LiDAR to it. Give our frame the name LiDAR frame and attach it to the chassis. And give it the specified pose 0.8, 0.5. Then we need to add the sensor plugin under the wall tag. Then we will add the LiDAR sensor to our chassis. We define the sensor name and its type. Then we define its pose relative to the LiDAR frame we defined above. Then in the topic, we specify the topic name on which the LiDAR data will be published. The update rate will be the rate at which the LiDAR data will be generated. Under the ray, we specify the properties of the LiDAR rays in the horizontal and in the vertical directions. Samples is the number of simulated LiDAR rays to generate their complete laser sweep cycle. Resolution. This number is multiplied by the samples to determine the number of range data points. Minimum angle and the maximum angle are the angle range of the generated rays. The same for the vertical. Under the range, we specify the minimum and the maximum distance for each LiDAR ray. The resolution tag here defines the linear resolution of each LiDAR ray. The always on, if true, the sensor will always be updated according to the update rate. And the visualize, if true, the sensor will be visualized in the GUI. The sensor is being visualized in the GUI depending on if the sensor supports visualization or not. The LiDAR message has the following attributes. We will focus on the ranges attribute. As we have the LiDAR on our robot, we can use the ranges data and make our robot avoid hitting the wall. First, we will build a node which subscribes to the LiDAR topic and read its data. There is a tutorial explaining how to build a publisher and a subscriber node. The link of the tutorial and the node we will use are in the description below. In the node, we start by including the libraries we will use, which is the twist message, the laser scan message, and also the node class. Then we define the topic, tmdvil, the topic which we'll be publishing on. We create an object from the node class and we create a publisher with message type twist. In the main, we define a topic sub, LiDAR, the topic we will subscribe to, and when we get a message, we will call the callback function. In the callback function, we read the ranges attribute of the message laser scan and check if all the rays are in range higher than 1. If true, set the linear attribute of the message to 0.5 and the angular attribute to 0, which will make our robot move forward. Else, if not true, which means the robot is about to hit the wall or close to the wall, we make the linear attribute to 0 and the angular attribute to 0.5, which will make our robot rotate until it is clear for it to move forward again. We need to build this node. Download the cmakelists file from the description and add it in the same directory of the LiDAR node and the SDE file. Open the terminal and create a build directory. CD into the directory, then build the file using cmake command. Build the node using make LiDAR node. Now let's try our node. Launch the world in one terminal. In another terminal, run the node. If we open our simulator, press the play button, we'll find our robot start moving forward, and when he approaches the obstacle, we'll start to rotate until the ranges of the rays are more than 1, so it will move forward again. Instead of running two different tasks from two different terminals, we can make a launch file which will run the sensor tutorial world and the LiDAR node at the same time. Open your text editor and add the following code. The launch file is an XML file. So, at the beginning of the launch file, we define the XML version we will use. Then, we add the ignition tag. The first command to run is the IGN Gazebo sensor tutorial .sdf, which will launch our world. We define these commands in the command tag under the executable tags. Then we add the command to launch our node. We give the executable the name LiDAR node, and then we specify the command to launch the LiDAR node. To run the launch file, use this command: ign launch. Then specify the name of the file. If we press the play button, we'll find that our robot started moving, which means the node is working. And when he approaches the wall, start rotating until it is clear, so he move forward. Now we have our robot moving and avoiding walls. See you in the next tutorial.